Still here. As you wish, my Thane.
If you need potions, head over to Angeline's Aromatics.
May the gods watch over your battles, friend.
It's so good to see you again.
Do you have business with the court? She still mourns greatly for her husband, High King Torric. So she leaves many of the courtly details to me. Well, by rights, she had a legitimate claim as High Queen of Skyrim. But now, Skyrim is at Ulfric's mercy. The Moot will meet and choose Ulfric as High King. With his troops in most of the cities, they have little choice. Because killing her would yield no political advantage. By leaving Elisif alive, Ulfric completes the separation of the Empire and Skyrim. With Ulfric's troops here, Elisif will be forced to support his bid for High King. He secures the position and appears above reproach. What's more, Ulfric's refusal to execute his slain enemy's wife will be portrayed as the ultimate act of compassion. It's genius, really.
Anyone
with a stout heart like yours is welcome here.
I have so very many ways to deal with people. Very few of them pleasant. I had you figured for a mage. I think you'll appreciate this. Take care of yourself, and always remember, the world is ripe with people looking to spill your blood.
We heading out?
As you will, my Thane. I will protect you with my life. I've got your back. I'll head back home if you need me.
Boost, Sibyl Stentor has a grasp of magical theory that I would never have expected from a human. No doubt most folk in Skyrim consider the dragons terrifying. I make sure Erica keeps breathing. No, that honor is Sibyl Stentor's. A smart man steers clear of Stentor, and keeps himself out of the dungeon when she's having a bad day. Working for Erica may be below my stature, but the compensation is acceptable.
Force, run!